In video number 3 here, what we want to talk about is complex number addition. Let's let z1 be a symbol that represents the complex number 4 plus 3i. We're going to let z2 be the complex number 2 plus 5i. And we're wondering, what does it mean to add z1 and z2? What should we get? The simplest thing to try, at least, is to say, hey, let's just ignore the fact that I squared equals negative 1 and treat these things as two linear polynomials in I and add like terms. Question might be, is that useful? Is it interesting? That kind of stuff. We're going to see that yes, it's useful and yes, it's interesting. So go ahead and do it. The real part of the answer should be the sum of the real parts of the sumands, z1 and z2, so I do 4 plus 2. And the imaginary part should be the sum of the imaginary parts in the original complex number z1 and z2, that's 3 plus 5. It's going to be the imaginary part of the answer, so I need it to be next to the I. Now simplify, we get 6 plus 8i. An immediate benefit of this approach is we see right away that the commutative property will hold. z1 plus z2 should be the same as z2 plus z1. And the reason is because the real numbers are commutative under addition as well. If I do this calculation, I get the exact same answer, 6 plus 8i.